Yeah, actually, before I go in there, so we have this F1 here, that's meaning this is using filament 1.
Uh-huh.
If we change the gate, it would say filament 2 if we change the filament.
Mm-hmm.
This SP5 and SP6, those are the vacuum interlock relays.
Do you recommend that we alternate between filaments? Or just run one until it burns and then switch to 2?
Usually
or?
I just go with the same one until it's done.
Okay, good.
Because then when that one burns up, then you can maybe consider getting a new gauge so you have it ready for when the second one goes.
Right? Yeah.
So you're kind of bouncing between the two.
You never know, yeah. So SP5 and SP6, you said they are?
They are the vacuum interlock relays that are controlled by this gauge.
Mm-hmm.
Right now this gauge is out of range, that's why it's saying it's below -3. I'll go into the setup here. This is the two relays. They're enabled below 1 torr.
Mm-hmm.
So if we vent the chamber, then the vacuum interlock becomes interrupted. In here we can set what our atmosphere value is. So here we are at 760 torr. But if you're at something else in El Paso, you can change that here.
Mm-hmm.
And then atmosphere calibration. So when the chamber is vented, I press enter here and I change that no to a yes. You say make sure your pressure is equal to atmosphere. You press enter, and that's going to make the gauge read whatever you've defined here. So that's
okay.
Going to do the calibration for this gauge.
Mm-hmm.
Calibration is not too critical with this gauge though, is it? Because its primary function is just for the vacuum interlock switch.
So mm-hmm.
It doesn't really have to have precision. That's about it. There's nothing else you'd really want to change. You can zero on the low side, but that's, again, that's not.